Yeah, let's check out Night Fighter Ace here in our board game weeks. Similar to Interceptor Ace, but focusing on the nighttime and the nighttime allied bomber raids. And you are part of the German Night Fighter Force and try to respond to it. Good. Yeah, I can show you what different aircraft are available and versions. Quite a lot of airframes, and yeah, I wanted to pick something special this time. I will fly the Dornier 345. This thing was only concept art, never hit service, but yeah, I think it is also interesting to fly a what if or a fictional aircraft. This will be our Night Fighter, let's equip it. Yeah, we will launch from Bremen, I would say. But Dutch base is also interesting. I didn't check on this intruder mechanic. When you operate from a Dutch base, there's an intruder mechanic. But yeah, we will launch from Bremen. And yeah, unit. As this was a fictional unit, there's no need to check which unit we belong, and it is the Nachtjägergeschwader or Nachtjägergeschwader first. That goes not on the map, that goes here somewhere. Great target. Yeah, we will start as an officer. This means we get one experience point. Which I might invest into landing skill. Yeah, I read some about the night fighters. Especially in the early days, they took heavy casualties not to enemy contact, but because of accidents. I think landing skills is even more important, as the chance to crash at night be taken lightly. And this costs 1 point, so I will invest this into my experience. Yeah, normally I would fill out the support game, or if you download or design it yourself, it comes a patrol sortie, a patrol sheet you need to fill out also with your crew in order to track them. First, we will roll for raid target, see if we can even reach it. We have an aircraft that is available in June 44. Normally, campaign starts August 43 if you pick the BF-110 and can later change to another aircraft. June 44. Everybody's going for France. Demon is not too good. Oh. This side. Rail yards in France. We can France, I don't know. They always will go for France. We are rather sitting at not the best base. There's a chance they will go for Ruhr, which will make it easier. But we have a chance to intercept them on the way. Good. Next, we need to check for weather and moon phase. Three is good weather. And the next year, moon phase, I can't find but I remember it was something like you roll a d10, 3, 6, 9, 10. It was in a manual. You have a 3 that is a full moon, Raid target is France. And we are moving to take off. Little plane. Ah, hier. Gut, wir haben einen Takeoff-Slot. We need to roll for every time we move. We can roll for interception. Normally the far away, the less time you have for interception. Move here, you normally have then little time to intercept. If they would for example go for Bremen, you could do way more. But as I remember, we need to go directly to France and then we have the rest for interception. I'm not entirely sure again. Well, you can check sequence of play, but I think that is also mentioned here. Yeah, move from the takeoff endurance box to the raid. Okay, yeah, it is like this. First, I wanted to check the electronics check is made beforehand. Exactly. On B4. And if some of our electronics we are carrying a main radar. Which gives us better interception at night. And a warning device, which will help. With the mosquitoes. In case there is a mosquito night fighter. Which will fight like a dog fight. Ah, but there's only one passing. It is not really a dog fight at night. He might gain the initiative and might fire on you. And that's it. If you gain the initiative, you can fire on him, because at night there's not really possibility for a real dogfight. Those guys operated under really severe conditions. Low risk. Good. B2D6 is that? 9. No effect. Okay, nothing failed, which is not that uncommon. Look at this table. We are launching for France with our 335 Donier. Good. Let's check if we can make the interception. We have little time before landing because we had to go such a long way. We get, +2 to our roll. If we are unsure of the location, it's off. So 9-7 or higher. Yep, that was nothing. But we get another chance. We need to check for an event. Ah, we need. When is this performed, random event? I think at the beginning, D1 is read it properly. Yeah, this one and this. on the interception table. I need to check again when the random event is called. Okay, last chance. Wait, we have full moon. 6, 8. Is it full moon? Yeah. 8 plus 2 interception skill. We made it. We found them with our advanced aircraft, thanks to its technology. Good. We are intercepting, and now we will roll what we are intercepting. It's July 44. Nine. We intercepting a Lancaster. Lancaster is here. Lancaster has a speed of 14. We have a speed of 21. That's him on the board, isn't it? That is absolutely no problem. Now we will decide on what distance I want to start. Which I said, patience for board games back in the 80s, I happily sit down and devote hours to them, but now I struggle with the idea, would love this on an iPad or something. Yeah, that would be great. You mean automated, with rules applied by software, do you mean playing the board game digital? Okay, we will start at medium range. And the attack card will decide if we are spotted or not. In the first combat round, we might do damage first. However, there will be still defensive fire. We are not spotted. You fire first. Good. So let's first resolve. Yeah, we have a combat power of 12 as our forward guns. We are not equipped with schräge Musik. Yeah. Those weapons that fired upwards in order to damage the bomber from below. And the Stirling is equipped with a rear gunner. And the Mosquitoes are not. We will now battle it out with the tail gunner. Ah yeah, I also need to declare where I'm targeting. Yeah, keep it simple, I'm targeting the center. You can target wings. Airframe, aim at gunner, airframe, aim at wing. Seems like aiming at gunner and airframe doesn't make really a difference. When I add at the group damage it makes. Yeah, I'm aiming at the airframe. And next. We are ready to fire. Yeah, we could also go for an extended burst, that's what I was looking for, but we'll give you more hits on the target. But it will also it has a chance to blind your pilot because of the extended muzzle flashes. And I think the enemy will receive bonus to the defensive fire. So we have a firepower of 12. We are applying 5 damage to the bomber. We said we are aiming for the airframe. So we will roll 5 times 10. And damage marker here. Rose. And also, I spent 2 ammo. Was written on the card. You're not spotted, you fire first bomb against corkscrewing next turn. Okay. That's usually what they do. Corkscrewing will remove one or two hits. So the controllers are hit. Six. The gunner is hit. Tail gunner is killed. Tail gunner is killed. This means he can't fire back. Or is, I think there is no wounded. Not for the bomber. Guy's down. This means we can now approach close range. Yeah, close range. There is a chance that the bomber might violently explode or something. At least that was in the day thing. That a thing in the Night Fighter version. That the bomber might explode somewhere. The group damage or whatever. Who knows? Okay, whatever. The gunner is down. This means we can now relax. I mean, normally a pilot wouldn't know that. This darkness, you couldn't see that, but let's say the entire cupola came up or whatever. He's firing out. It's obvious that this guy is not there anymore. Got damage. He scored 5 hits, right? Yeah. Five is again controls. One more hit and the bomber crashes. That is for the B-17, but the Lancaster can only take 3. Engine port. I think it is randomly all one die. 4 is second engine. And airframe hit. Good, yeah, that was the run. I mean, we could pull the defensive fire card, because I don't know if I will encounter another bomber. Normally, now the gunner would shoot back, at least on those bombers that are equipped with a tail gunner. Except for the Mosquito is alone. And would score 2 hits on you. But that is not the case. Okay, I think we are allowed 3 times to come in. The bomber is now defenseless. Box crewing, I think it is removing a hit. Yeah, exactly. Box screwing is removing one random hit. Is this an operational rear gunner? Okay. So one, we need to remove one hit with the next card. We get group damage on the airframe, but also target now a wing. When the gunner is down, I declare. On the other hand, if you hit the controls one more time, the bomber crashes. So let's stick with frame. Group damage for frame is. We also need to do a roll for. Here. Yeah, okay, that was already done. Auto 6 is outer engine. The engine. Group damage is here. Group damage on airframe. Yeah, it's done. Group damage on the airframe is one control. On airframe and three randoms. Or maybe we'll roll, but the bomber is crashing already. Don't need to do it. You get the idea. We don't need to beat a dead horse. Yeah, the control threshold damage is reached. Bomber is crashing. Often need them. Down them. Gibt es Text hier. Oh, schräge Musik. In case we once use it one time. Yeah, the bomber is going down. I will reset everything. And then you would protocol one Lancaster down on your sheet or write it down somewhere. And that's it. I think we won't find another bomber that fast. Only in a bomber stream you are allowed to intercept multiple bombers. Sometimes those night fighters found themselves in a bomber stream where they shot down several bombers in short time. In really short time. Multiple bombers, because they were basically inside a formation and shot them down one by one. Hey Artem. This means we now need to go for the landing. But with this weather conditions, full moon, weather should be fine. But yeah, if the weather is bad and you have little environmental light, then you crash. I can show it to you. Yeah, I mean, the chance for crashing always is one. It's a 2d6 roll. That is okay. But it gets quickly, you know, with weather and everything. I mean, we basically will not fail it. Yeah. We have also landing skill. But if you have damage and bad weather, poor weather and whatever, moon. Yeah, good, moon is only -1. Then it gets quickly rough. Yeah, let's roll for the landing. And have a rough landing. I think that is the worst. Is that even possible? Rough landing, we have 10. No, we have good weather is -1. We have full and yeah, we can't. We don't need even to roll. We will have a safe landing with equipment. Yeah, we are fine. And back in Bremen. And are rearming our. No damage, one bomber downed. Yeah, because the Target is so far away, we had no time to intercept other bombers. Yeah, and first kill squad. I think first bomber skill is already, let me see. Definitely a prestige point. Already know. And the Iron Cross. Second play. Which gives you another prestige as far as I know. One prestige for the first kill. Or is that included? And we gain some fatigue, okay. I think that is already included in them in the AK2. I think it is separate. So there's one prestige point. That a B17 kill is special. Vito Nightfighter kill is also special. Yeah, and two fatigue we got. No, one fatigue. Two fatigues, minus two fatigues if you sit on the ground. Yeah. Yeah, that was 130 with our here. Yeah, prototype aircraft. And yeah, check it out. One of those commander games I find quite interesting. And I think once you have the rules, I think it is a bit simpler, definitely, as Interceptor Ace, no question. Interceptor Ace was released afterwards, and you notice that Interceptor Ace is a bit more detailed, also not too detailed. I think it could even have a bit more complexity, especially when it comes to the RPG aspect. But if you think that is even, yeah, if you look a good entry title, I think that here is probably the most straightforward compared to Interceptor Ace. If you can't decide between those two and don't have a preference, for example, for the history of Night Fighters, throw this into your consideration. Okay, that's it. Oh wait, there's a message. Board game week continues, nice. Will you do long walk through of one of these games? Yeah, good question. I need to see. I was planning to play a bit more Shadow War. I bought it on Vazal. There's one I'm interested in that is, but there is no digital version of it. That is the Hunted. That is the late U-Boat campaign. And I heard people are really saying it is very hard to survive. Yeah, because it is basically late submarines. Late German submarining in the Atlantic. And that was, of course, extremely difficult to survive there. That was really desperate times. 33 upwards. And that, I think, is very interesting. Perhaps one day. Yeah, and others, we will see. I also plan to do U-Boat Leader, and but longer playthrough, I need to see. Okay. Good hunting.